going to jump to Tom Panos in the Sydney CBD studio. I'm sure he's got something pretty straightforward for us this week. Welcome, Tom.
Hi, Chris. Hi, Charles.
G'day, Tom.
And that was a pretty different one. I guess have you ever seen anything like that before?
No, first time I've ever seen it. First time.
So we're all learning, aren't we, Tom?
Absolutely. That's whereabouts was that property? In what area?
That was around Bondi Beach.
Bondi Beach, okay.
Yeah, very unique. But, okay. Yeah, what have you got for us?
Yeah, in Melbourne, Gisborne South. Just spoke to the agent, Ken Gresh. This property here, he's got a price guide of $1.575 million to $1.65 million, so over $1.5 million. We're talking about 15 acres of grazing and leisure garden, a great property that's got 6 acres of garden itself. It's a former Italian Renaissance, and the location here, Charles will be able to tell you, he spends a lot of time in Melbourne. It's about 45 minutes from the CBD. You get easy access through, I think it's called a freeway, and it's a unique property itself. It's got a tennis court. The name of the property is Jacaranda, double story with balconies, so go and have a look at it. I think there's I said it last week on the show, Chris, that I think the rest of December is a good buying opportunity, and go test this vendor out at $1.575 million as a price guide.
That seems an enormous property for 45 minutes out of town.
Yeah, well, you know, the area that Tom's talking about is a beautiful area, like a lot of green out there. And in Melbourne, you can get that very easily once you get out of the CBD, unlike Sydney, where you've got to travel a lot more distance to get what you're seeing in this particular property.
Yeah, that sounds ridiculously large.
Acres of gardens. Now, all you have to think about is how many apartments you could build on that, Chris. That's all you need to think
exactly.
about.
Exactly. I might get in trouble about that. Okay, property two, Tom.
Property two, 26 Wattle Street, Killara. Okay, so this one's special. It was in our North Shore Times, and it's presented by Glenn Curran from Curran Property. Now, let me just tell you that this property will be breaking the record that currently has been set at $11.5 million in 2011. So this property, Ballernoo, will set the new record in the Upper North Shore. We are talking about a 4,050 square metre block. We are talking about two separate titles. It is a trophy heritage listed home that has beautiful craftsmanship inside it. It's got an interesting blend of being a Federation home, but it is fully operated by new technology. So we're talking about everything can be operated by an iPad interface, the whole property. Lights, you know, pools, you name it, operated. And it was owned in the 1930s. It was the home of the Sydney Stock Exchange chairman, Clarence de Geurt. I think I've said it right. But this property here, 26 Wattle Street, will be breaking the record. We are talking 15 million plus.
Tom, I reckon you and I and Charles might be happy there. There's probably room for all of us around the dining table there.
It would be. Tom, is that the first time this property's come up for sale? Because it looks familiar.
Charles, I'm not sure if this has been on the market in recent times. I don't have the sales history on it. But if it looks familiar, is it one that you've previously owned, Charles?
No, mate. Remember, I'm a Crookwell boy and I live in the Blue Mountains in a humble cottage, and I'm very happy there. Thank you.
Yeah, anyway. That's too much in the big smoke for Tom.
Way too much.
What else are you seeing out in the market, Tom?
I'm seeing a lot of properties that are being withdrawn from auction. I'm seeing a lot of properties that are being sold prior to auction with one buyer. I'm seeing a lot of vendors that are saying, you know what, I'm not prepared to risk it. If you've got a buyer, let's sell it. And I'm seeing a lot of real estate agents that have realised that no longer is the marketplace going to create a sale, that they've got to bring in some traditional salesmanship, and something that Charles knows about. You take buyers out, you look after their needs, you find something that they like, versus them coming to an open house and having to fight over a property versus other buyers. What we're seeing is the return of the salesman.
Tom, we always say that there are two types of markets in real estate. One where you get the buyer up to meet the seller's ridiculously high price, and that's called a boom. And the other where you get the seller down to meet the purchaser's ridiculously low offer, and that's called real estate. And that's what we're in 90% of the time, and that's where we're heading right now.
And that comes from that very great textbook, Charles, that you wrote about 25 years ago. It still sits in my study there. And I don't like saying it, but I occasionally do plagiarise a few of your lines, Charles.
Finally, you're admitting to it, Tom. That's fantastic. Thanks, mate.
It's interesting coming this into the Christmas time, because I always find with Christmas there's a break over like a month or two for the real estate world. But it's interesting to know, because no one knows what it's going to be like when we reopen in January or February. And so it's a really telling time for people if they're going to take the offer now, kind of before or after Christmas.
Yeah. Chris, I've got to tell you, we had a real estate function for all our News Corp clients, about 1,000 agents in a room on Tuesday night. And I've got to tell you, I see a lot of agents that are nervous, because what they're saying is when they come back in the new year, they're going to be able to tell late January, early February, what it's really going to be like. They're hoping at the moment that this marketplace that's eased in recent times has eased, because there's been an oversupply of listings that have hit the market with sellers wanting to sell before Christmas. What they want to see is what's going to happen when they go back to their normal selling season. Some of them appear quite nervous. Other real estate agents that haven't been having the boom period said, it's going to be business as usual. We will find a listing, we will find a buyer, and we will make a sale.
And that's really what it's about, Tom. And for the record, I plagiarised some of your stuff too, mate. So there you go.
Well, this is a good tape that we should get this on record, and you can send it to all your database, and I can send it to all of mine.
All right. Good on you, mate.
Good to see you, Tom. Thanks for seeing it, and we'll see you next week.
See you, gentlemen. Bye-bye.
And we'll be back in a few minutes, just after a short break.